Hey there, guys. Thanks for inviting me.
You're welcome. We were just about to get out the board game.
Quiet, you. I'm going to tell some stories now as an act of gratitude. Now, the first story I'm going to tell is a great story to spook anyone and get them in the mood for some other spooky stories. It's called The Headed Horseman.
Wait. Isn't it supposed to be The Headless Horseman? You silly old man.
But... No. The Headed Horseman. It's about a man who passed a head, but it's a horse head, and it's a man who has a horse head, and it's a man. Yeah, that's what it is. I meant to say
that's
that.
That's kind of strange.
No, it's what I meant to say, and I'm about to tell the story of the Headed Horseman.
Long ago, there was a man who traveled across the land telling stories to unsuspecting citizens. This story had been passed down from generations, from my father, Older Man Jenkins, his father, even Older Man Jenkins, and his father before him, Oldest Man Jenkins. That's who this story is about, you know, my great-grandfather, Oldest Man Jenkins. One day, Oldest Man Jenkins strolled into Old Town Allopolis in search of new listeners, to continue his storytelling mantra. Oldest Man Jenkins knew countless stories, from amazing tales of possessed bicycles to not-so-amazing tales about a man who mows the lawn. Many people willingly listened to his monologues, considering it was Halloween night and a full moon. Everyone was in the mood, so much so that Old Man Jenkins even received word of a Halloween festival similar to this one that was in need of spooky stories. Oldest Man Jenkins arrived at the Halloween-themed gathering and began unveiling his greatest stories. Everyone's attention was captivated by the masterpiece entitled Young Ivanstein. That is, everyone except for Grizzled Guy
Boo!
Gary.
Boo!
Grizzled Guy Gary was a rivaling storyteller who was between the ages of 45 and 60. He tried to best Old Man Jenkins with a story of his own, one that everyone seemed to be familiar with, the story of the headed horseman. Soon, everyone forgot about my great-grandfather's story and moved on with the party. Oldest Man Jenkins didn't want to leave right away because that would seem rude, so he just hung out in the back eating stale pretzels until the party was over. But now it was dark. Oldest Man Jenkins was impaired from eating too many stale pretzels, but decided to venture out anyway. He fumbled through the darkness and was unaware that someone or something was watching him. It was too late. No one was there to save him from the headed horseman.
And he was never heard from again, leaving behind his son, even Older Man Jenkins, to fend for himself. What did you think of that story? And now for our next story, an even spookier story. a knight to dismember.
Hey, I've already heard that one. It was in the Stooky Master Productions Halloween Special Volume 2. Wait, what's little Timmy doing? Did you eat all the pizza?
Hey, I haven't even had any yet.
Me neither, and I'm hungry.
Meh, 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 meh.
All right, everyone. Since I've already heard this story, I'll go take little Timmy to go get some more pizzas.
Mr. Dean, it sure is getting foggy all of a sudden.
Yes, little Timmy, it sure is. Which is peculiar considering it's 4 p.m. in the afternoon.
Mr. Dean, that sure did sound like galloping.
Yes, little Timmy, it sure did. Which is peculiar, considering we live in a metropolitan area, which wouldn't accommodate for horses very well.
Mr. Dean, that is sounding a lot like how Mr. Old Man Jenkins described the headed horseman stopping his victims.
Yes, little Timmy. It sure is, which is peculiar, considering that story was very clearly fictional.
Mr. Dean, that man sure did look like he had a horse head.
Yes, little Timmy, he sure did, which is peculiar considering horses generally don't stand in an upright position. Or wear clothing.
Mr. Dean, I'm scared.
Yes, little Timmy. Frankly, I'm quite spooked myself. Let's go.
Mr. Dean, why is the car alarm going off?
Well, little Timmy, this isn't my car. Well, little Timmy, we're safe now.
And we have pizza. Look, Mr. Dean, a shoe.
Oh, little Timmy.
And then he pulled out a shotgun and died next to his beloved hand in a standoff. The end.
Me, 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 me!
It was fine. Nothing much happened. What did we miss?
A really awful story. Even I can tell a better story than that.
Hey! I've told that story to dozens of unwilling audiences and they never had a problem with it.
Oh yeah? I can totally tell a better story than that.
I'd like to see you try. I bet you don't even know any spooky stories.
Sure I do. It all started this morning on the toilet. Thank you.
Hello, Weather Wizard. It's me, Shag Shagman, aka Super Shag. I left that note on your door because you're invited to a Halloween party, and it appears that my scooter has a flat tire, so could I get a ride?
Meh 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 meh!
Okay, maybe old man Jenkins was right.
Okay. Yeah, that's what I thought. You young whippersnappers can't even touch me in my domain. Storytelling. All right. Anyway, this next story will prove you all wrong. This is quite possibly the spookiest story ever told. And worst of all, it wasn't even that long ago.
I think Greg's in the bathroom.
Wait a minute, but didn't Greg die several years ago? Snare, 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 snare.
Oh!